Aircraft inspection with drones, that's what we do, Mike. All day, every day. Five years.
Long time, also very short time.
I knew this was gonna take forever.
Not me.
What?
Not me.
Liar, liar. You were also in the startup.
Huh?
You were also in the startup before.
Yeah, sure, but I knew I was optimistic as always. Oh yeah, sure, it's gonna be 3 years, then it's all certified, widespread adoption in the aviation industry. Guess what?
5 years.
Of course, it's been a long time, but we strongly believe in the idea of using drones for aircraft inspections. I'm very proud that I can show a drone nowadays that actually can fly its complete flight, automatically do the inspection, and that like a big airline, for example KLM, can actually use it now as a tool. So you guys were asking why I like Mainblades so much. It's basically because I do not have to fly manually anymore. I just swipe on my iPad and there the drone will go. And it will start doing its inspection by itself. What you see now is that the drone is performing this left wing inspection because there's this problem with the paint quality on top of the wings of 787s in general. As you can see, we're flying in a pretty confined area. But the program is, the drone is programmed in such a way that you feel very confident in using it. On the screen over here, you see like a 3D image of the airplane that we generated with our LiDAR system. You see a little symbol that represents the drone. And you see a blue dot, that's the area that needs to be taken a picture of. Since a couple of months, I can just talk with you, not even look at my screen all the time, and be confident that the drone will do exactly what our people from Mainblades programmed it to do. That's pretty great, isn't it?
It definitely feels rewarding in a sense, because at the beginning I was the only one being able to do an inspection because I was the only one knowing how the system worked. But now seeing people just getting the iPad and setting up an inspection and running it, it just rewards us because it's been a journey. It's been not that easy, of course, to make it possible for anyone to run an inspection basically, but that's the level that we are at now, and yeah, that's really rewarding.
I was technically I was an intern, but because we were such a small company, my opinion and like my work actually mattered a lot, and the same holds true for the other interns that started at that time.
I think that's really a nice thing here at Mainblades, that we get this freedom. If you have ideas, that you can bring them to the table, discuss them with your fellow engineers, and basically get to work on these kind of things.
What's particularly nice is that not only it gives you the chance to cover a lot of different technical fields and also very innovative technologies, but also it's a startup environment where everybody is very much involved, very much young environment, and a very lively one. There is never a boring thing, or there is never like a boring day of work. Very often we grab drinks after work. Me and a couple other employees also play some instruments, and we organize what we call a jam blade. So from time to time we just use the office space to just play instruments and have a little jam session, and that's something that I really, really enjoy.
If I work at a bigger company, maybe a car company or an aerospace company, you only work on like a tiny wheel on the big, you know, machine. But the main blades, that's not the case. You still work on a wheel, but you also have to put all the wheels together and like think and you know, you have to keep the bigger picture in mind.
And that is really fulfilling because you notice not only the product is growing, but also we as persons and as engineers are, and we are immediately able to put it back into the product.
Of course, we started with a much older drone and very looking like a prototype, just taped together just to make it work. While nowadays, almost 3 years after, you can clearly see the difference of a very reliable and robust product that just does everything, every time, the things that you would expect it to do. And although this sounds obvious, it's not always that obvious in robotics.
Doing that in hangar environments around aircraft, yeah, it's amazing to see your feature flying there on the drone in the air. And
this again is part of not necessarily maturing the company, but you see that our technology is getting more mature. And that allows us to keep a much steadier pace on the development that we do.
Even if we're testing something, it's not experimental anymore. We know what it's gonna do.
Yeah.
It's stable, we can show it to customers. So that's a great, great progress we made.
Of course, the technical part was a challenge, but also the communication with a large company and to get like the regulators in line with our idea. There was a bit of a struggle, but so step by step we came to the point where we are now.
Shit worked.
The product.
Yeah.
The product works.
Yeah.
The product we've been building for 5 years.
5 years.